So our next service is, next exemption is on construction services. First of all, construction is a service which is written in schedule 2. You remember, material plus labor, but it is considered as service. Alright. So service provided by way of pure labor contract. Pure labor contract. I'm not bringing any material into it. Pure labor contract. Okay. For construction, erection, commissioning, installation, completion, fitting out, repair, maintenance, renovation, alteration of a civil structure or any other original work pertaining to the beneficiary-led individual house construction or enhancement under which scheme? Housing for All, okay, or Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. That means by default pure labor, labor contract is taxable. By default labor contract is taxable. But if you are doing labor contract under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, then it is exempt. Am I clear? Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana exempt. Next. Electricity distribution utilities. You must have seen that the big transformers, no? When you go on highway or railway, you see big towers, electrical wires. Alright. So company which are managing that electricity utilization and distribution utilities, those company services are exempt. Hello? So Reliance Power, Tata Power, okay. So those companies are exempt. Electricity distribution and that utilities. Pure labor contract for construction of single residential unit. Okay. Now when you go to your villages, in Mumbai we don't have single residential units, very rare to find unless and until you are super rich. But usually in villages what happen, we give contract to construct our home to one person. And that guy constructs only one house. Yes or no? Construction of single unit is exempt. Construction of single unit. If you give him contract of construction 5-6 unit, okay, then it is taxable. If you give him contract to construct building, then it is taxable. But if you give him contract to construct single unit, it is
exempt.
Am I clear? And you won't believe, Mukesh Ambani also have taken benefit of this. His tower, entire tower, is a single unit. Although it is a tower, according to government registration, it is a single unit. So single unit of any cost, cost is not required here. Even if it is of 1000 crore, if it is a single unit, it is exempt. Are you getting this? Okay. So it is exempt. It should be residential and it should not be part of residential complex. It should not be part of residential complex means some builder, what they will do? This is the residential complex they are developing and they will say at a time you should construct only one house. So it is a single unit. Then this is a single unit. Then this is a single. No. If it is a part of residential complex, then it is taxable. Single means single. You understand? Single means single. Only one unit. Hello? If like it is like this, then it is not taxable. Are you clear getting this? Okay, next. Next. TDR and FSI. Okay. Ignore this for time being. Next, I need to see the amendment date. If it is there in syllabus, then only I'll teach. Easy items we will do first. Passenger transportation service. Passenger transportation service. From entry number 6, government entry. Transportation of goods and transportation of passenger was taxable. Yes or no? Because it is removed from entry number 6. But I told you it is covered by some other entry. And this is that entry. Entry number 15, which covers passenger transportation. Therefore, you must observe this. When you are going to use this passenger transport mediums, you need to see whether they are charging GST or they are not charging GST. Am I clear? Yeah. So what is not taxable? The first is air transport. First exemption is air transport. And I call this particular place as the best upman. Okay. Best upman. I call it best upman. Why do I call it best upman? So this is only for northeast region. Okay. So air transportation is taxable. I pay a lot of GST because I always go to South India, not to northeast India. Hello? Are you getting? So air transportation is taxable. Only if you are traveling through best upman, then only it is not taxable. So what is best upman? B for Bagdogra, located in West Bengal. S is Sikkim, T is Tripura, Arunachal Pradesh. Hello? And M is having 3 M, no, that you know that 3 M's, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Assam and Nagaland. if you are traveling from this particular places, okay, so there are two words. Either you are embarking. Embarking means you are getting into the flight. Okay, so that is embarking. Or you are getting down from flight. That is terminating. Hello? Either you are starting from base tapman or you are terminating in base tapman. So Mumbai to Nagaland, taxable or not taxable? Not taxable. Nagaland to Delhi, not taxable. Are you getting? Whether destination is Nagaland or whether source is Nagaland, both cases it is not taxable. Government wanted to encourage air transportation to that area. Okay, and let me tell you, cost is very high. Already air transportation cost to this area is high. Okay, by putting GST it will become more costlier. Hello? So this is how government is trying to balance that particular air transportation. So only one exception for air transportation. Secondly, non-AC contract carriage, okay, and non-AC stage carriage. Non-AC stage carriage other than non-AC. So in Mumbai we are having two types of buses, AC buses and non-AC buses. AC buses are taxable, non-AC buses are exempt. Okay, stage carriage means if bus has started from Dadar, okay, and if it is going to come to Andheri, hello, it is going to stop at various places, yes or no?
Yes.
So this bus is called as stage carriage because every stage some passengers will get down and some passengers will board the bus, yes or no?
Yes.
All right, so this is the stage carriage. If it is the AC, taxable. If it is non-AC, exempt. Am I clear? Yeah. What is contract carriage? Contract carriage usually start at one station and directly it will stop at, and I'm not saying in between it will not stop, it will stop, but passengers will not change usually.
Yes.
Passengers will be the same. That is contract carriage. If it is non, if again if it is AC, Nita Volvo, taxable. Hello? Nita Volvo, taxable because it is AC bus. Are you getting this? If it is a non-AC bus, then only it is not taxable, but it should not be radio taxi. It should not be
radio.
So what is the radio taxi? Radio taxi is Ola Uber. Now Ola Uber is whether AC or non-AC. Okay, because the radio taxi means taxi which runs on GPS system, GPRS system. Hello? Alright, whether it is AC Ola or non-AC Ola Uber. Am I clear? Alright, it is taxable. Secondly, it should be for transportation of passenger. It should be for, if you want this exemption, it should be for transportation of passenger. That means it should not be for tourism. Alright, tomorrow if I have to take you all on picnic and if I take one non-AC bus, hello, it's not passenger transportation, no, it's a tourism purpose or conducted tour or charter or hire. Hello? For marriage people take buses on hire, for some party they take on. So not for that, it should be passenger transportation. So what is the exemption? Exemption is given for passenger transportation where any random passenger can take a ticket and get into the bus. Am I clear? If it is for these four purpose, tourism, conducted tour, charter or hire, okay, then it is by default taxable. Even if it is non-AC, it is taxable. What if it is AC? Don't ask about AC. AC by default, because who travel by AC? Rich people. Rich people can afford by paying some extra tax. Am I clear? Hello? Non-AC passenger transportation, not taxable. Conducted tour, taxable. Am I clear? Little difficult to remember. You need to read it again and again, and we have made handwritten notes for this. Okay? Next. Now government is starting some small airports, okay, small airports which are regional connectivity airports. Alright, whatever it is, if you are providing services to those airports, earlier it was exempt up to only 1 year. Earlier it was exempt only up to 1 year. Now the time limit has increased to 3 years. So regional connectivity airport services, is earlier it was exempt up to 1 year, now it is exempt up to 3 years. That is Ministry of Civil Aviation. Some initiative is there. Next, services of transportation of passenger with or without accompanying belonging, that means with luggage, without luggage. Okay, so railway is exempt. Look at here, railway is, earlier exemption was for airway and contract carriage and stage carriage, yes or no? Here railway, now we are talking about, so earlier exemption bus and air is exempt to some extent. Am I clear? Now we are talking about railway is exempt. But other than two class, which two class?
First class and
AC coach. Rich people, taxable, poor people, not taxable. Okay. Metro, mono and tramway. So one of the student was saying metro is AC, but still metro is exempt. Yes or no? It is not exempt in clause A, it is exempt in clause B, separate clause. Alright. What is monorail? In Mumbai we are having monorail also, no? Wadala to Dadar, Dadar somewhere, no? Wadala to Chembur. Okay. That monorail is there, small railway. Okay. So that is, it looks like a toy train. It starts at one point, ends at second point, from there it take passenger, comes here. Metro at least have two ways, no? Up metro and down metro. This is a very small train. Okay, sometime only one track will be there. Okay, yeah. What is tramway? Tramway you must have seen in some Salman Khan songs and all. Okay, that heroine is sitting inside that wooden type of railway. Okay, which is running on road itself. Okay, and then Salman Khan is, you know, cycling and then singing song for her. Kind of thing. Yeah. So that is tramway. Okay, usually it is available in Kolkata side. Yeah. Railway on road, you can say.
Yes.
Inland waterways, so this is a river and you have to cross river. Every day you have to cross river. So some inland waterways are there, some boat services are there. So it is not taxable. Okay. Public transport, very important word, public transport, not private cruise and all. If you are having boat parties and all, it is taxable. Here I am talking about public transport by vessel. Public transport by vessel. You come to Kerala, there are lot of public transport available by using vessel. By vessel, okay. So usually there is a place called Kottayam, okay. Near Kottayam there is this lake called Kumaragam, okay. Now in Kumaragam what happens, you know, you can take your private boat on hire and pay 5 to 10,000 rupees, and in season sometime 25,000 rupees up to. Alright, and you can stay in that boat and they will take you some round, and then you can, you know, they will provide you food and some services. This is up to this 10 to 15,000 or 5 to 8,000 depending upon the boat size and how many people you are going to travel by that boat. That is a private boat. If you wanted to have same experience, not same experience but boat experience, okay, and you don't want food, okay, food you can carry in your own bag, then you can enjoy the same boat ride for more than 1 or 2 hours, more than 3 hours sometimes, okay, by paying just 10 rupees to 15 rupees. Yeah. Now 10 to 15 rupees is a bus kind of thing, it's a vessel, okay, but run by Kerala government. That is not for tourism purpose, that is for passenger transportation. But boat is boat, no, you can sit in a boat for 3 hours, you go there. Usually people go from one location to another location for some work and all. You people, we people go there, we sit in this place, we go to the next place. We enjoy 3 hours journey by paying 15 to 18 rupees. Hello? Then second boat we take from there and come back. 6 hours boat journey in 50 rupees, full enjoy. Yeah, so sunset and all, you take photographs, everything available in 50 rupees. Alternatively, you can pay 5,000 and 10,000 and enjoy the same. But along with food and little more comfort, because it will be private boat for you. Hello? Alright. So if you are travelling by public transportation, which is other than for tourism purpose, it's not for tourism purpose, then it is not taxable. Yes or no? Okay? Good, no?
Yes.
Yeah? Meter cap. This is like yellow and black taxis that we are having in Mumbai. Meter cap. Okay? Auto rickshaws are not taxable, including e-rickshaw. E-rickshaw is like electrical vehicles which don't use fuel, they use batteries. Okay? So they are also not taxable. So these are the exemption given for passenger transportation. Services provided by transportation of passenger on a vessel from Kolkata to Port Blair. Kolkata to? So that side of the, okay. So mainland to island. Port Blair is an island, okay. And Port Blair to Rose Island is covered under item D. Entry number center. Is it a passenger transport? Is it for tourism purpose?
No,
there is no road. From land you have to go to island. There is no road. Only one way you can go. That is by using vessel. So people who are staying there, they have to go by vessel. So it is exempt. Okay, not taxable. Passenger transportation not taxable. Okay. The way we discuss transportation of passenger, we have to discuss exemptions of transportation of goods. Alright. So goods transportation is also exempt. Okay. But which goods transport are exemption? First, we are talking by road. Goods transport by road. So by road, whatever goods transportation happens. So hath gadi, kuli, alright, horse, elephant, everything is exempt. Except two means goods transport agency, that is GTA. I told you GTA is taxable in reverse charge mechanism, and there are certain special exemption for GTA that we are going to discuss now. Alright, and courier agency. Why courier agency is taxable? In fact, government itself is paying tax on couriers, no? Yes, speed post is also taxable, yes or no?
Yes.
So these private couriers are taxable or not taxable?
Taxable.
Next to our building only there are private couriers, no? They are taxable or not taxable?
Taxable.
Department of Post is taxable and private couriers must be taxable. So two road transport vehicle, transportation of goods by using road, only two are taxable. Which two? GT and courier. Balance all other mode of transportations are exempt. Okay. Inland waterway, just the way I told you for passenger, even goods can be transported by using inland waterways. Okay. Next, this is transportation by rail or vessel. Transportation by rail or vessel. One thing is for sure, goods transportation by air is not exempt. Passenger transportation by air was also exempt only for that best of month places.
Yes.
Hello? Goods transport by air. If you are transporting goods by air, that means you are a super rich person. Yes or no? You might be transporting gold, diamond, we don't know, something precious. Because you are using air transportation. Road transportation exempt, vessel transportation exempt, railway transportation exempt. But not for all products. Selected product. Can you see this selected product for rail and vessel? Alright. The first thing is the relief material. Relief material. So Kerala flood happens, so whole India or some states of India, they provided some relief material to Kerala. Karnataka flood happened, Maharashtra flood happened, obviously other state they provide some help. Alright. Those goods will also be transported by railway. Railway is not that shameless that to take GST on those receipts. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. So relief material is not taxable. Defense and military equipments, that is also not taxable. No need to provide logic. You are providing services to defense by providing transportation of defense material, not taxable. Newspaper and magazines are also not taxable. Railway is transporting railway equipments, that is also not taxable. Agriculture producers are not taxable. Milk, salt, food grain including flour, pulses and rice, that is also not taxable. Organic manure is also not taxable. Apart from this product, if you transport any other product, it will be taxable. Garment, shoes, watches, yes or no? Iron, steel, any other thing you transport by using railway and vessel, it is taxable. Not exempt. Okay? Sir, services provided by GTA. Services provided by GTA. I told you we don't mess with GTA because government is afraid of them. Goods transport agent are having all India unions, and whenever we make any law against them, we are afraid. Hello?
Yes.
We get tense because they have unity so strong that they can shut down whole India for indefinite period, and if they shut down the India for indefinite period, you will not get any vegetable, any milk, any raw material, any finished goods in the market. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Therefore, government always try to keep them happy. Okay, so they said, first of all, we don't want to pay tax. We said, okay, your tax will be paid under reverse charge mechanism. Then they said, we want so many exemptions. We said, okay, no problem. Whatever exemption you want, we will give you exemption. Hello? So exemptions, some exemptions are common, so I don't have to read it again. Okay, agriculture produce, then milk, salt, food grain. All right, organic manure, newspaper, magazine, relief material, defense material. One observation point, if I ask you to find out difference between this and this, alright, so railway equipment is not here.
Yes.
Hello? Railway equipment by railway and vessel is exempt, but railway equipment by GT is taxable because it is not here. In exemption, we don't have railway equipment. So railway equipment is missing here. This is one observation. Apart from that, we got two more additional exemptions here. Okay? One first exemption says, where total truck value, hello, total consignment value. So all consignees together. Okay, together means I have two parties. This is my truck. This is my truck, and here I have two parties consignment. From here, from this guy I have charged 700 rupees, and from this guy I have charged say for example, not 700, let's take 200 rupees, and from one guy I have charged 900 rupees. One guy I have charged 900. This is I have charged from A and this is I have charged from B to deliver these two commodities. Am I clear? So total value is how much? 1100. If total value does not exceed 1500, then it is exempt. Look at the language. If does not exceed 1500, then it is exempt. They did not say up to 1500 exempt. Hello?
Yes.
This language is different language. That means if it was exceeding, if this is also exceeding 900, then total value is exceeding
1500.
So how much is taxable?
1800.
Because this is a condition. This is not limit. This is a
condition.
Whenever they use language of up to, that becomes limit. Whenever they use language does not exceed, it becomes condition. So what if it exceeds? This is how you should ask me. If it doesn't exceed 1500, it's okay, it's not taxable. What if it exceeds 1500? Taxable, whole amount taxable. Am I clear? Sure?
Yes.
Can I go ahead? Now there is another exemption which is 750. Another exemption which is? Student get confused in 1500 and 750 because there are two exemption limits written here. Now this is my truck, okay, this is my truck and there are three parties, okay. Party A 700, party B 800 and party C 900. Can you see ABC? Yeah. So total value exceeds 1500, yes or no? First you have to check that total value exceeds, so it is taxable, okay. They have to pay tax. Party C will pay tax, party B will pay tax, but party A will not pay tax. Why? Because consignee wise party A is paying less than 750. Hello? So there are two exemptions. Total, first of all, truck exemption, whether truck is taxable or exempt, that we have to check. So if truck value is up to, for up to earlier example, if truck value is up to 1500, then you don't have to take tax from either A or B. You don't have to take tax from them. But if it exceeds 1500, then people will pay tax. Your consignees will pay tax. But which consignee will pay tax? Consignee whose freight charges is more than 750. If any consignee charges is less than 750, then he should not pay tax. So this example you should remember. Okay? So this guy will pay tax, this guy will pay tax, this guy will not pay tax. What if there is only one consignment going? 900 rupees, shall he pay tax?
No.
Why? Because the total value is less than 1500. What if there is one consignment going here, 2400? Why? Because it is more than 1500, at the same time it is more than 750 also. Okay. What if the total value, okay, 700, 700 and 700, A, B, C, tell me, total value exceed 1500. Nobody will pay tax. Why? Single consignee wise it is not exceeding. So when tax will be paid? When total value exceeds 1500 and consignee wise value exceeds 750. Total value exceeds 1500 and consignee wise value exceeds 750, then only tax will be paid. Are you getting this? Sure? Yeah? If you are confused, then you can ask me again. So this was GTA exemption. One more exemption has come, but not that important. GTA to unregistered person. Why this exemption is given? Because GTA is taxable under reverse charge basis. Yes or no? If GTA is providing tax to unregistered person, any of that unregistered person is not going to pay any tax. Like you are changing your house. So if you are changing your house, you will appoint one GTA to transport your cupboard, bed, house furniture, yes or no? Are you registered under GST? No, but GTA is providing you services. Hello? So who is responsible to pay GST to government of India? You people. Do you think you are going to get registered and pay GST there?
No.
Are you getting this? Therefore, services provided by GTA to unregistered person is not taxable, it is exempt. It is exempt. Services provided by GTA to central government, state government and union territory is also exempt. Hello? Services provided by GTA to government. GTA providing services to government. Reverse charge mechanism will apply? Hello? Government saying, but in reverse, we are supposed to pay tax. No, we don't want to pay tax.
Yes.
So what is happening? Services provided by GTA to government or government establishment. Hello, government or government is not taxable. Example, new entry has been added. Entry number 21B. So this was that goods passenger transportation and goods transportation. If you have any doubt, then let me pause video for some time and then I'll continue.